The HackRF Portapack is an impressive handheld SDR transceiver, capable of emulating wireless remotes, tracking aeroplanes, decoding wireless data, and a lot more. If you've just received your Portapack, you'll need to do a few things to take full advantage of its capabilities. Or if you're having problems with your device, this video might be helpful. If you haven't watched my introduction video on the HackRF Portapack, go watch that first. This video is for those of you who need to set your HackRF Portapack up for the first time or are having troubles flashing the firmware onto the device. The video is divided into chapters to make it easier to point people to the part that's relevant to their situation. Chapter 1. Basic information. The currently actively developed firmware for the HackRF Portapack is called Mayhem. Since the HackRF Portapack project is open source, there are several different hardware manufacturers and several slightly different variants available. There are some devices that are not supported by the Mayhem firmware, so check with the GitHub wiki to make sure you get a supported device. The HackRF Portapack is actually made from two separately available circuit boards, although they can also be purchased as an assembled device, which is probably what you want. The HackRF board is originally designed to be used on its own with SDR software on a computer connected through USB. The Portapack board adds a screen and controls and enables HackRF to be used on the go. The assembled Portapack H2 devices comes with a battery and a built-in charging circuit. To turn on your HackRF Portapack, press the rotary encoder once. To turn it off, press it twice. The battery level is indicated by four LEDs surrounding the rotary encoder. Charge the battery by plugging in a USB charger. If you plug into a computer, it will take a very long time to charge. While charging, the device will automatically turn on and cannot be turned off until you unplug it. When you get your HackRF Portapack, it most likely will come with some version of Mayhem already installed, but it probably won't come with an SD card, and you need an SD card with the correct files on it to use a lot of the features of the Portapack. I'll get back to how to set up your SD card for the first time in Chapter 3 of this video. First, I will cover how to update your Portapack if you've already previously set up your SD card and have a working install of Mayhem on it that you just want to update to the latest firmware version. Chapter 2. Mayhem Hub Web Interface. Mayhem Hub is a web interface available at hackrf.app, used for controlling a HackRF Portapack connected with a USB cable. In the bottom left corner of the screen of your Portapack, is displayed what firmware version of Mayhem is currently installed. You will need to be running firmware version 2.0 or nightly N24.01.14 or newer to use the Mayhem Hub. If you're running an older version of the firmware, or if you haven't set up your SD card yet, skip ahead to Chapter 3. With Mayhem Hub, you can control your HackRF Portapack and see a preview of the screen. You can upload and download files from it. You can run serial commands and you can update the firmware of the device. To update the firmware, scroll down and click on the Manage Firmware button. Here you can choose if you want the stable firmware release or if you want to try the latest bleeding edge nightly firmware build. Simply click one of the buttons and the Portapack will be automatically updated and the new applications will be loaded into the apps folder as well. Chapter 3. Set up SD card and use flash utility. If you've just received your HackRF Portapack and you haven't yet set up an SD card for it, or maybe you're using an older version of Mayhem that isn't working with Mayhem Hub, or Mayhem Hub just isn't working for you, then this is what you need to do. Go to the Portapack Mayhem GitHub, and on the right side you will see where it says Releases. Click the latest version here. Scroll to the bottom where it says Assets, then click on the item that says Mayhem V and the version number. Copy to SD card. Do not download the files by cloning or downloading the GitHub repository, because that folder does not contain the needed ADSB map for plane tracking. You only get that if you download from the releases page. You now need to format your SD card as a FAT32 device. Unzip the file you've downloaded. It contains a bunch of folders named ADSB, AIS, apps, and so on. All of these need to be copied to the root of the SD card. Especially the apps folder is important, since many of the applications on the Portapack are located within this folder and will not appear if you don't have an SD card inserted with this folder on it. Once the files have been copied over, You take your SD card and insert it into the Portapack and turn it on. It can be a bit difficult to get the SD card in and out if you don't have long fingernails, so I suggest using the stylus to make it easier. In the bottom left corner of the screen is displayed what firmware version of Mayhem that is currently installed. If this version number matches the version number of the files you've downloaded to the SD card, then you should now see that all of the applications are available and you can start using your Portapack. If the version numbers do match, but you still do not see the missing applications, try using a different SD card and make sure you formatted it as FAT32 and that you've correctly put the folders in the root of the SD card. If the version numbers do not match, then the applications will be grayed out because the applications on the SD card can only run on the firmware version they are specifically made for, and you will have to update to that firmware. To do this, simply navigate to the Utilities menu on the Portapack and select the Flash Utility. You will now be presented by the contents of the firmware folder on the SD card. And by default, the files you've downloaded will contain the release version binary of the firmware, which you can select on this screen to install. It will take a few seconds and the device should reboot, and you should now be able of using your HackRF Portapack and all of its applications. Chapter 4. Flashing through USB. If you are for some reason unable to use the built-in flash utility on the Portapack, here's what to try next. This guide assumes that you're using Windows. Go to the Portapack Mayhem GitHub, and on the right side you will see where it says Releases. Click the latest version here. Scroll to the bottom where it says Assets. Download the file named Mayhem V and the version number Firmware. Unzip the file and open the folder. At this point, you need to plug your HackRF Portapack into your computer using a USB cable. When you plug in your Portapack, the version of Mayhem that is already installed should be booting up, just like when you turn it on normally. If Mayhem isn't installed or not working at all, jump ahead in this video to Chapter 5 about DFU Recovery. But for now, we will assume that Mayhem is working. On the Portapack, navigate to the menu item called HackRF and press it and click Yes. On your computer, you can now run the file named flash_portapack_mayhem.bat and press any key to begin the process. Once the process has finished, unplug the USB cable and the Portapack should now reboot into a working Mayhem firmware. If you manage to successfully install the firmware, remember that you still need to copy over the SD card files from the releases page as explained in Chapter 3, especially the apps folder, to make sure that you have the correct version of the apps installed. If the updater cannot connect to your device, and you are sure that it is plugged in and in HackRF mode, try a different cable, or you might need to install the driver, which is included in the driver folder. Chapter 5. DFU Recovery. If all else has failed so far, don't worry, it is basically impossible to software break the HackRF because you can always do a DFU recovery, even if you don't have a working install of Mayhem on the device. This is how. This guide assumes that you're using Windows. Go to the Portapack Mayhem GitHub, and on the right side you will see where it says Releases. Click the latest version here. Scroll to the bottom where it says Assets. Download the file name Mayhem V and the version number Firmware. Unzip the file and open the folder. Unplug and turn off your Portapack. On the top of the Portapack there are two buttons. The one closest to the middle is the DFU button. Hold down this button while plugging your Portapack into the computer using a USB cable. The green LED on the top should light up, but the screen should remain black. Now run the dfu_hackrf_1.bat file from the firmware folder that you've downloaded previously. Press any key to begin the DFU process. For now, just ignore any warnings that you might get. Do not disconnect the Portapack once the procedure is done. While the Portapack remains connected, now run flash_portapack_mayhem.bat and press any key to begin the process. Once this is finished, unplug your Portapack and it should reboot into a working Mayhem firmware. If you manage to successfully install the firmware, remember that you still need to copy over the SD card files from the releases page, as explained in Chapter 3, especially the apps folder to make sure that you have the correct version of the apps installed. If it doesn't work, try installing the driver located in the driver folder, or try using a different USB cable. Chapter 6. Other troubleshooting. Hopefully you should by now have a fully functioning HackRF Portapack. But if you are experiencing unstable behavior, or some apps are not working as they are supposed to, there are still a couple of things that you could try. If you experience the screen turning off when transmitting, this actually isn't a bug, but a feature. It's called stealth mode and is toggled by pressing the little detective icon in the top bar. If you want to avoid accidentally enabling this feature, go to Settings, User Interface, and here you can choose what icons are shown or hidden in the top bar. The Portapack has a small real-time clock button cell battery on it that keeps not only time, but also some settings variables. Differences between firmware versions of this persistent memory might cause issues. You can reset the persistent memory by navigating to Settings and selecting P Memory Management. Here you can select Reset P Memory to defaults. Another thing you can try is to update the CPLD chip on the HackRF. I won't go through this procedure in this video, as it is a bit more involved, and it will require you to set up an environment for running the HackRF command line tools. You can read how to do this, along with other troubleshooting guides, on the Mayhem GitHub wiki. I hope this video has been helpful in getting your HackRF Portapack up and running. But if you're still having problems, come on over to the Mayhem Discord and we will try and help you there.